In today's world, most autocrats are different from the traditional model of dictatorship. The new autocrats do not repress thousands or tens of thousands. They also don't have an official ideology. They try to convince the public that they are democrats and they should be loved, they should be popular rather than feared. And that completely transforms the nature of the political regime. So our research doesn't classify regimes into black and white. And many people who look like informational autocrats and actually use the tools of informational autocrats are running democratic society. And we see that President of the US, Donald Trump, has authoritarian leanings, and he does use his Twitter as a tool of overcoming evidence, overcoming information coming from mainstream media and from progressive politicians. He wants to subvert democratic checks and balances and rule of law. And in that sense, there is a lot to learn from our research to understand how modern American presidency works. We can only speculate why and how the dictatorships of the past have been replaced by this new informational, softer autocracies. And there are a few reasons. One is the end of the Cold War. Under the Cold War, both the East and the West supported the brutal regimes, even though they, on paper, didn't like the brutality. Now, another reason is, of course, globalization and development of new technology. So it's much harder to hide brutality today. It's also much harder to develop in autarky. Interestingly, the rise of informational autocracies suggests that democracy is actually prevailing, in the sense that informational autocracies don't present themselves as an alternative to democracy. They want to blend in. They want to pretend to be democracies. They understand that the public wants to live in a democracy, real or pretended. And in that sense, the very rise of informational autocracies proves that the democratic model of government remains the most popular model of government around the world. We need to battle this regime in the informational sphere. Informational autocrats wield their power based on manipulation of information, and they have to be challenged in the informational sphere. And mostly, that means today, online. So far, populists and informational autocrats around the world have been outperforming the liberal Democrats in the new media. And the liberal Democrats, the progressive politicians, people who are committed to European value, have to rise up to this challenge and be more active and convincing, not just in mainstream media, but also online, in the social media. And our research also suggests that we can be optimistic. Why? Because as long as we have the march of progress, as long as we have more people understanding what's going on, better informed, seeing how it is actually better to live in a society based on European values, the harder it is for informational autocrats to sustain their regimes.